So it's 2022, and I firmly believe that you should switch to DaVinci Resolve from whatever you're currently using, and I want to give you a handful of reasons why. Make sure you stick around, because at some point in this video, I'm going to tell you how to win a DaVinci Resolve studio license that I'm going to be giving away. Add more creative light to your mobile filmmaking kit with B-Script's brand new RGB LED light panel. With over 96 CRI, 1600 LUT, this light is perfect for any shooting scenario. Packed with features like 9 special lighting effects, it also works as a power bank, bringing extra life to your phone and other accessories. Learn more about B-Script's brand new RGB on-camera light down in the description below. Listen, all of the major NLEs, Final Cut, Premiere, Resolve, they share like 90% of the same features. And as creators, we all like to do and edit things a little bit differently. So you're not gonna hurt me if you end up not switching to Resolve, and I'm not gonna hurt you by making this video. All right, so the first feature is BlackMagic Cloud. This is their cloud service where you can basically store your entire library in their new hosting software. So for $5 a month, you get to store a database. Now, the real purpose of this that they showed off in all of their keynotes and stuff was to basically collaborate with other creators. Maybe you have a remote colorist or remote editor. But even as someone who's primarily a solo creator, it's really nice to have, because I can have access to my database, back it up, download it if I need to, from any computer anywhere, optimized for M1 Macs. DaVinci Resolve has become so optimized on Mac that it is borderline outperforming Final Cut Pro, because they are coming out with so many big updates so quickly. Now, this is kind of a new side application with DaVinci Resolve 18, and that is the proxy generator. And it allows you to set up a watch folder so that anytime media is added into that folder, it will automatically start creating proxies using one of the proxy presets that you can choose from when you first load up this program. Definitely the easiest selling point, and kind of where no one can really debate, is the color page. Noise reduction, this is one of the features that is different from the free version to the paid version. Honestly, it's one of the best noise reduction plugins out there. It creates a really clean image, it takes away a lot of the color noise. Color Warper was a tool that came out last year, and this basically allows you to select any color in your image, and then it's gonna show you where it is on the color wheel, and you can just simply drag it to any part of the color wheel. Most of the time, you're dragging it back to the middle to kind of like almost white balance correct. But this is such a fast and easy tool to use, I love it. And then the brand new object track, which just came out in beta 2 of Resolve 18, you essentially can just draw lines, kind of selecting it, hit the track forward button, and that's pretty much it. So honestly, if you're looking to test out DaVinci Resolve for yourself, I am going to give away one license to the studio full version. All you guys have to do is comment down below what is your favorite feature in Resolve that you're excited to test out. This doesn't have to be one of the new features from Resolve 18 or a new feature I've mentioned in this video. There's just so much packed into the software that I don't use in my workflow. If you made it to this point in the video and you're like, that all looks really cool, but X is the reason why I'm still not switching over. Again, besides just I'm really happy with whatever piece of software I'm using, that's a totally valid response. There's probably one of three things, or it could be all three things, holding you back from switching. The first one is nodes. I'm right there with you. I freaked out when I first saw this crazy complex node tree, but I promise you, if you just like spend a couple of hours playing around, edit a couple YouTube videos or whatever projects and get used to the node tree, you will never be able to go back to layer-based editing, and you'll be like, that is the dumbest form of color correcting that I've ever seen. The next thing, also totally get, custom windows. With Premiere, you can literally attach and detach every single window. And so when you have like a 3 monitor setup like me, you can put things basically exactly where you want them to. In Resolve, you do have multiple monitor support, and you can kind of choose what windows are in view and not in view, but you can't get as specific as like, oh, I wanna put my source viewer here and then my media bin right below this. And honestly, I get it. It annoys me to this day that I can't fully customize it, but it's one of those things, if that's the only reason holding you back from switching and you see the other benefits of switching, you're gonna get used to it within like a week. Don't let that be the one thing holding you back. And last thing, and probably one of the hardest, is templates and presets. Adobe products are some of the most widely used out there, and Final Cut isn't far behind. And so there are a ton of YouTube tutorials, preset packs, templates that you can buy online. And I totally get being hooked into that ecosystem and having that stuff. All I can say is that DaVinci Resolve has come up a lot. And so a lot of the places that never offered preset packs before for Resolve now do. Motion VFX is definitely my favorite. You can check them out in the links in the description below. Or places like Motion Array also have an entire Resolve library built out. There you guys go. Those are a bunch of reasons why I think you should test out DaVinci Resolve 18. Remember, there's a free version that has like 90% of the features. So even if you don't want to put any money into it, you can check it out in the link in the description. And of course, if you want all the super pro features like noise reduction and a bunch of other things, check out the studio version and comment down below so you may win a studio license from me. Thanks so much for watching, guys. I'll see you in the next video.